Welcome to Discovery School's virtual learning platform. Good day, Basic 8 students. Today we shall be looking at mathematics, and today we shall be also looking at angles, properties of angles. Number one, angles on a straight line sum up to 180 degrees. In other words, the sum of the angles in a straight line is equals to 180 degrees. The sum of the angles in a straight line equals to 180 degrees. So let's take example. If you have an angle, if here is O, here is A, here is B, here is C, and here is 60 degrees, and here is X. We have two angles on this straight line, so the sum of this angle plus this angle will give us what, 180 degrees. In other words, angle AOB plus angle BOC is equals to 180 degrees. These two angles sum to 180 degrees. What is angle AOB? Angle AOB is 60 degrees plus angle BOC is X unknown equals to 180 degrees. To get X, you collect like terms. 60 degrees crosses equal to and changes to what? Minus or subtract 60 from both sides. Anyone that is convenient for you. So our X will now give us what? 180 minus 60. And X will give us 180 minus 60 is 120 degrees. So X is 120 degrees. In other words, 60 degrees plus 120 degrees equals to 180 degrees. Let's take another one. If we have, let's say, three angles on a straight line. We have here to be X. Or let's use Y this time. Here to be Y, and here to be 45 degrees, and here to be 55 degrees. Let's call here A, B, C, and D. And the center point is O. We have three angles here: angle AOB, angle BOC, and angle COD. So by using the law or the property, we say the sum of angles on a straight line is equal to 180 degrees. We have, therefore, angle AOB, you can use this sign or the other sign we used before, plus angle BOC, plus angle COD, is equal to 180 degrees. In bracket, you must put sum of angles on a straight line. Sum of angles on a straight what? Line. So what is angle AOB? Angle AOB is Y plus what is angle BOC? Angle BOC is 45 degrees plus what is angle COD? Angle COD is 55 degrees is equals to 180 degrees. Your Y plus 45 plus 55 will give us 100. 45 plus 55 will give us 100 degrees, equals to 180 degrees. Collect like terms. When this one crosses equal to, change to what? Minus. So we have Y is equals to 180 minus 100. So our Y will give us 180 minus 100 is 80 degrees. Therefore, angle AOB is equals to 80 degrees. So if you put 80 here and add up the three together, they must give you 180 degrees. 80 plus 45 is 125, and 125 plus 55 is 180 degrees. Therefore, the sum of the angles in a straight line is equals to 180 degrees. So even if you have up to four angles or five angles, all you need to do, sum up the angles together and equate it as 180 degrees and do your sum. At the end of the day, you get that unknown angle. Property two, angles at a point sum up to what? 360 degrees. That means the sum of the angles at a point is equal to 360 degrees. Angles at a point, just take a point. Any angle that is formed or that is generated from that point is angles at a point. So let's take an example. We have this. Okay, let's add one to get to it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These angles are called angles at a point. Let's call the center here, which is 0. Let's call here A, let's call here B, let's call here C, let's call here D, and let's call here E. It therefore means that for to get these angles at a point, angle AOB plus angle BOC plus angle COD plus angle DOE plus angle AOE is equals to 360 degrees. Assuming we are given certain portions, let's say we are given here to be A, and here to be 40 degrees, here to be, let's say, 100 degrees, here to be 35 degrees, and here to be 75 degrees. So you are looking for this point. In other words, it means that you sum all the angles together, equate it to 360 degrees. So from what we have done, AOB plus BOC plus COD plus DOE plus AOE sum to what? 360 degrees. So what is angle AOB? Angle AOB is A. Plus, what is angle BOC? Angle BOC is 40 degrees. What is angle COD? It is 100 degrees. What is angle DOE? It's 35 degrees. What is angle AOE? 75 degrees. How many angles? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They sum to what? 360 degrees. All we need to do is have to say A plus 40 plus 100 is 140. 140 plus 35, 175. 175 plus 75 is 250. 250 is equals to what? 360 degrees. So what do you do? You collect like terms. When plus 250 crosses equal to change to what? Minus 250. Or you subtract 250 from both sides. Therefore, your A will give us 360 degrees minus 250. So 360 degrees minus 250 degrees will give us what? 110 degrees. It therefore means that angle AOB is 110 degrees. To know whether you are correct, put 110. If you add up everything together, it will give you 360 degrees. Let's take another example. You have something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have here to be 120 degrees. We have here to be Y. We have here to be 60 degrees. And we have here to be, let's say, 45 degrees. 45 degrees. And we are asked to look for Y. Okay, let's increase here to let's say 78 degrees. And we have here to be Y. Let's call here M, N, P, Q. So the center is O at the center. So we are looking for Y. This is angles at a point, which sums to what? 360 degrees. So you can say by angle MON, angle MON, angle MON plus angle NOP, angle NOP plus angle POQ, POQ plus angle QOM, QOM will give us what? 1, 2, 3, 4. There are four angles, 360 degrees. What is angle MON? MON is 78 degrees. What is angle NOP? NOP is 60 degrees. What is angle POQ? POQ is Y. And what is angle QOM? QOM is 120 degrees, is equals to 360 degrees. Let's calculate. 78 plus 60, that will give us 138. 138 plus 120, 238, 258 degrees plus Y equals to 360 degrees. You collect like terms. It's either you subtract this from both sides or you move over. Okay, let's say subtract 258 from both sides. So you have 258 minus 258 plus Y equals to 360 minus 258 degrees. So this minus this is zero. We now have Y equals to 360 minus 258. If you subtract 258 minus from 360, you have 102 degrees. It therefore means that Y, which is angle POQ, is equals to 102 degrees. To know if you are correct, put 102 here and add up everything together. It will give you what? 360 degrees. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. When we say vertically opposite angles, we mean this. Vertically opposite. This is vertically opposite to this, and this is vertically opposite to this. We call here A, B, C, D. It means that angle AOB is what? Equal to angle COD. Angle COD, they are called what? Vertically opposite angle. Vertically opposite angles. Then angle AOC, angle AOC is the same as angle BOD. Angle BOD, they are also called vertically opposite angles. And the rule says that vertically opposite angles are equal. If here is 60 degrees, let's assume here is 60 degrees. If here is 60 degrees, it therefore means that here is 60 degrees. So let's assume you are giving one part of this triangle and you are told to look for side A, side B, and side C. Side A, side B, side C. There are so many ways of solving this. Mind you that this is an angle on a straight line. This is angle on a straight line, but these are vertically opposite. So you can solve from any side. So if you want to get B, you can say therefore angle A O B is equals to angle COD, which is equals to B. And that is equals to what? 60 degrees. In bracket, you say vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Then if you have gotten B now, it is easier for you to get A. 60 degrees and angle A, they are on the straight line. You can say angle AOB plus angle BOD is equals to what? Their angle equals to 180 degrees. Angles on a straight line. angles on a straight line. Angles on a straight line. Therefore, AOB is 60 plus A. Isn't it? BOD is A. Angle A we are looking for now equals to 180 degrees. To get A, you move 60 over to this side, becomes what? Minus. Your A will give us 180 minus 60. A will give us what? 180 degrees minus 60 degrees. And that will give us 120 degrees. It therefore means that angle what? A, which is BOD is equals to 120 degrees. Then to get C, if you know A, you can know C. They are vertically opposite angles. You can say that angle BOD is equals to angle AOC, which is equals to angle AOC is C, and which is what? 120 degrees. They are called what? Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, A is equals to 120 degrees, B is equals to 60 degrees, and C is equals to 120 degrees. Number four, when a transversal cuts parallel lines, the following are true. For example, this is a parallel line. This is a parallel line. It shows that a transversal is something like this. When a transversal cuts a parallel line, or I've shown you two parallel lines, cut parallel lines. This is a parallel line. This is a parallel line B. This is a transversal. So when it cut parallel line, the following are true. Number one, or the A, shows that alternate angles are equal. Alternate angles are equal. Alternate angles are equal. Alternate angles are equal. Number B, corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. Number three, the sum of the interior angles. The sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees. Alternate angles are equal. Corresponding angles are what? Equal. Alternate angles are what? Equal. Corresponding angles are equal. The first one we talked about vertically opposite angles. Then we are talking about alternate angles. When we say alternate angles are what? Equal. Okay, alternate angles are equal, corresponding angles are equal, the sum of the interior angles is equal to what? 180 degrees. So let us look at alternate angles. What do we mean by alternate angles? Any Z angle is called an alternate angle. Any Z angle is called an alternate angle. Let's look at Z. Here, give us Z. So this angle is alternating this angle. Are we there? If I call here A, okay, let me start by calling here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So angle C is alternate angle F. And the reverse of it is the same thing. While angle D is alternate to angle E. Angle C is alternate to angle F. Angle D is alternate to angle E. Therefore, we say angle what? Angle C is equals to what? F. They are called alternate angles. Then also, angle D equal to angle E. Angle D equal to angle E, they are called alternate angles. Angle D equal to angle E, alternate angles. Angle C equals to F, alternate angles. In other words, they are equal. If here is 40 degrees, here will be 40 degrees. If here is 140 degrees, here will be 140 degrees. Whatever this angle gives you, that's the same thing as this what? Angle. So they are called alternate angles. They are called what? Alternate angles. That's A. Then B, we shall be looking at what? Corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. We said corresponding angles are equal. Which angle corresponds to A here? Angle A, E, angle E corresponds to angle A. They are the same thing. If you look at the pattern, they are the same. They are similar shape, isn't it? If you look at this to this and this to this, they are similar. So we call it corresponding angles. So angle A is corresponding to angle E, while angle B corresponds to angle F. A corresponds to E, and B corresponds to F. So whatever A gives you is same as E. Whatever B gives you is same as what F. So we can say that angle A is equals to angle E. They are called corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. And also, we can say angle B equals to angle F. They are also called corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. Whatsoever angle A gives you, same as angle E. Whatsoever angle B gives you is the same thing as angle F. Is that clear? Then the next one we want to look at is the sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees. What are the interior angles? What are the interior angles? What are the what? Interior angles. For example, see, if you look at this box now, C and E are interior angles. D and F are what? Interior angles. I repeat, angles C and E, they are called the interior angles of this, while angle D and F are called interior angles. That means C plus E will give us what? 180 degrees. And angle D plus F will give us what? 180 what? Degrees. So C, we can say that the sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, angle C plus angle E is equals to 180 degrees, while angle D plus angle F is equals to 180 degrees. They are called interior angles, and they sum to what? 180 degrees. Let's take example on that. We are giving something like this. This is a parallel and transversal cutting them. Let's say we only know here to be 110 degrees. And we'll call here A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And we'll say find the lettered angles above. Find the letter angles above. There are so many ways of solving this. Angle A and 110 are on a straight line. So A plus this will give us 180. We can get A. Is that clear? Angle 110 and also B, they are also on a straight line. This plus this can give us 180. Or by the time you get A is alternating, A is vertically opposite B. A is vertically opposite B. So whatsoever A gives is the same thing as what? B. And whatsoever 110 gives is C, because they are also what? Vertically opposite. They are also vertically opposite. So let's start our solving by saying 110 degrees plus A equals to 180 degrees is called angles on a straight. You must put the law or the property on a straight line. Therefore, to get A, when this one crosses equal to change to minus, your A will give us 180 degrees minus 110 degrees. Your A will give us 70 degrees. You can easily say that A equals to B. A equals to B, which equals to what? 70 degrees. It is called what? Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, B equals to 70 degrees. You can say C equals to 110 degrees, because they are also what? Vertically opposite angles. Now we are using all the laws. So C equals to what? 110 degrees is called what? Vertically opposite angles. Then, to get D, you can say D equals 110 degrees. They are called corresponding angles. D equals 110 degrees, corresponding angles. Or you say B plus D equals 180 degrees. Sum of angles, of interior angles. Is that clear? So you can solve it in any form. We can either say that D equals to 110 degrees, you can say it is called what? Corresponding angles. Corresponding angles, because D corresponds to 110. Or you can say B plus D equals to 180 degrees. That is what? Sum of interior angles. Sum of interior angles. So if, and we know that B is 70. 70 plus D equals to 180 degrees. Collect like terms. When 70 cross change to minus, your D is same as 180 minus 70. Your D will still give us 110 degrees. You can use any method to solve it. Then your E, we said Z angle is called what? Can you remember Z angle? We said Z angles are called alternate angles. Z angles are called what? Alternate angles. So we can say E equals to B. E equals to B. And what is B? B is 70 degrees. B is what? 70 degrees. We say E equal to B, and B is what? 70 degrees. Therefore, E will now be what? 70 degrees. And they are called what? They are called alternate angles. Alternate angles. Therefore, E equals to 70 degrees. Or better still, if you know D and E, they are on a straight line. So D is 110. 110 plus E equals to 180. 110 minus 180 will give us 70. They are still the same thing. Is that clear? Then E is vertically opposite to F. E is vertically opposite to what? F. E equals to F. And if E is 70, F will be what? 70. They are called vertically opposite angles. There are so many ways to solving this. Therefore, F equal to 70 degrees. And lastly, F and G are on a straight line. So if F is 70, G will be what? 70 minus 110, which is 70 minus 180, 180, which is what? 110 degrees. Or better still, you can say D and G, they are vertically opposite. And if D is what? 110, therefore G will be what? 110 degrees. So we can say D is equals to G, and D is what? 110 degrees. They are called vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Therefore, G equals to 110 degrees. You can actually use so many methods in solving it. You can actually use so many methods in solving it. From what we've been teaching you since, we said number one, angles on a straight line is equals to 180 degrees. Number one, we say angles on a straight line is equals to 180 degrees. Angles on a straight line is equals to 180 degrees. Number two, we said vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Then number three, we talk about angles at a point. Angles at a point sum to 360 what? Degrees. And number four, we said when a traversal cuts parallel lines, the following are true. Number one, we said alternate angles are equal. Number two, we said corresponding angles are equal. And number three, we said the sum of the interior angles is equal to 180 degrees. So you can do this activity for me. So for your activity 1A, find the marked angles below. Here you are looking for A, this sum to 180, you know that. Here you are looking for B, you can do that. Here you are looking for Y. The same thing as Y plus 10 plus 38 equals to 180 degrees, then you look for Y. Here, number four, you are looking for A, B, and C. Mind you, this sign shows that here is 90 degrees. So here shows that here is 90 degrees. So these two, they are on the straight line. If you can get 138, A plus this, they are on the straight line, you can get this. And once you get this, it will be easier for you to get your B and your C, because if here is 90 degrees, B plus C must give you 90 degrees. And you can easily solve that. You can easily solve what? That. Then the next one, number five, this is Y plus 20, Y plus 60, and plus 150, they are on the, at a point. So you can easily solve that. That's for activity 1A. Then for activity 1B, refer to page 84 to 87 of your mathematics workbook and answer questions 1 to 5. So this is your first lesson, your lesson 1. So make sure you do everything, lesson 1 to 5, and bring your book on Friday for us to mark. Thank you very much. I hope you had a nice day with us. God bless you.
A lot. You can join us via our website at www.discoveryschoolsng.com. You can visit us at our Agbawo campus, 11, 21, 23, and 25, Benin Technical College Road, Agbawo, Benin City, and at Upper Mission, 268 Upper Mission Road, Benin City. Thank you.